Malaysia to build hospital in Bangladesh for Rohingya refugees. Malaysia and Qatar sign 4 MOUs. Good evening. Thanks for joining us. You're watching News on 2 with me, Mohammed Amin Carlos. Well, Malaysia will build a field hospital at a cost of 3.5 million ringgit at the refugee camp housing the Rohingya ethnic community in Kujupalong, Cox's Bazar, Bangladesh. Deputy Prime Minister Dato Sri Dr. Ahmad Zahid Hamidi, in his visit to the refugee camp, said the hospital will be built by the Armed Forces Military Corps and the Health Ministry and will be completed within a month.
Kita sedang menunggu prosedur yang ditentukan oleh Kerajaan Bangladesh untuk membenarkan hospital itu, dan kami telah pun mendapat kebenaran daripada Perdana Menteri Bangladesh sendiri, Sheikh Hasina. Dan kelulusan ini telah diberikan kepada Pesuruhjaya Tinggi Bangladesh di Kuala Lumpur kepada saya dan Kerajaan Malaysia, khususnya Angkatan Tentera Malaysia dan juga Kementerian Kesihatan Malaysia telah memperoleh kebenaran itu. Dan insyaAllah dalam tempoh sebulan, hospital Medan itu akan beroperasi sepenuhnya.
Dato' Sri Dr. Ahmad Zahid pointed out that in the early stages, 35 medical personnel, including doctors, nurses and hospital assistants, will be stationed in the hospital, which can accommodate about 50 patients. Malaysia was one of the first countries to send humanitarian aid for Rohingya refugees, especially in the Kutupalong camp. Dato' Sri Dr. Ahmad Zahid said this after witnessing for himself the situation of Rohingya refugees at the Kutupalong camp.
Well, Malaysia and Qatar signed 4 Memoranda of Understanding, or MOUs, to forge closer ties between the two governments. Now, the MOUs involve bilateral cooperation in the training of diplomats, higher education, legal cooperatives and cooperation activities, and judicial cooperation. Now, the signing ceremony was witnessed by Prime Minister Dato' Sri Najib Tun Razak and the Qatari Emir Sheikh Tamim Hamad Al Thani in Putrajaya today. Foreign Minister Dato' Sri Anifa Aman represented Malaysia in the signing of the MOUs on the training of diplomats and higher education cooperation, while Qatar was represented by its Foreign Minister Sheikh Mohammed Abdul Rahman Al Thani. Sheikh Mohammed also signed the MOU on legal cooperation activities, while Malaysia was represented by Attorney General Tan Sri Mohammed Abdi Ali. And Dato' Sri Najib and Emir Sheikh Tamim earlier held a restricted meeting before heading to the delegation meeting between the two countries at Sri Perdana. The High Court fixed November 10th for the re-mention of the case of the 5 students of Universiti Pertahanan Nasional Malaysia, UPNM, who were allegedly involved in the death of a Marine Cadet Officer Zulfarhan Osman Zulkarnain, 21, back in May. Now, the date was finalized by Senior Assistant Registrar Nur Ain Mustafa. And Deputy Public Prosecutor Nur Akmal Farhan Aziz said that part of the documents, including the post-mortem report, had been handed over to the defense. The 5 accused, Muhammad Akmal Azamuddin, Muhammad Najib, Muhammad Afif and Muhammad Sobirin, had previously been charged under Section 302 of the Penal Code for the murder of Zulfarhan Osman. The case of Abdul Hakim Farhan Aziz, who is charged under Section 109 of the Penal Code for allegedly conspiring with the 5 accused, was also moved to the High Court. Meanwhile, 13 other students who were accused of charges of deliberately wounding Zulfarhan will be re-mentioned on October 27th in front of the Magistrates' Court. On June 14th, all of them pleaded not guilty to charges of intentionally causing injury to Zulfarhan with the aim of extorting confession of a laptop theft in room 410, Jabat Hostel Block, UPNM, Sungai Besi, on May 21st and 22nd. The victim died after sustaining severe injuries over all parts of the body due to abuse by a steam iron. Former Road Transport Department RTD Deputy Director General of Operations Dr. Yusuf Ayub was convicted for driving on the emergency lane and was fined a maximum 2,000 ringgit by the Putrajaya Magistrate Court today. He had on July 25th claimed trial to the offence, which took place on October 7, 2016 at 6:27 p.m. at Lingkaran Putrajaya. And Magistrate Muhammad Zaki Abdul Kudos also ordered Dr. Yusuf to face a 4-month imprisonment should he failed to pay the fine. Dr. Yusuf was charged under Section 119, Subsection 1, Sub C, and which can be sentenced under Section 119, Subsection 2 of the Road Transport Act in 1987, of which provides for a maximum fine of 2,000 ringgit or a jail term of up to 6 months upon conviction. Dr. Yusuf was first charged with the offense on July 18th, but was not in court then. Instead, he sent a special aide to represent him and pleaded guilty to the charge. He was fined 600 ringgit for the offense, which was paid by the aide. Well, Dr. Yusuf's case was, however, sent back to the magistrate's court following a revision by the Kuala Lumpur High Court after he failed to turn up in court for the hearing. Now, the fine of 600 ringgit paid earlier was refunded and the case was retried before another magistrate. A total of 39 individuals in Sarawak were arrested last week for involvement in gambling activities. And Sarawak Criminal Investigation Department, Dato' Dave Kumar, in confirming this, said the arrests were made during 33 anti-gambling raids following public complaints about illegal gambling activities in the area. Now, Kenyalang Park in Kuching received the most complaints about the sale of illegal lottery tickets. And Kuching also recorded the most number of raids conducted, with 6 raids within a week. Well, 4,855 ringgit was also seized, as well as items used as gambling equipment such as mobile phones, printers and calculators. And all those arrested, including a 16-year-old boy, are being investigated under the Common Gaming Houses Act 1953. A Bintulu Police NCID team on Saturday thwarted a drug syndicate's attempt to deliver ecstasy pills to the district via an express bus. Well, a local man in his 30s had also been arrested to facilitate investigation.
The suspect was detained as he was retrieving 2 packages at the Medan Jaya bus terminal in Bintulu. Upon inspection of the packages, police discovered 200 ecstasy pills in them.
Daripada sidikan kita telah tahan sebab maklumat yang kita perolehi. Maklumat yang kita perolehi, kita tahan beliau. Dan hasil daripada risikan tersebut, kita tahan. Pasal itu ada pada dia, kita buka pasal ini mengandungi ecstasy.
Police also seized a 4-wheel drive vehicle, a mobile phone, bank cards and 2 keys. The case is being investigated under Section 39B of the Dangerous Drugs Act 1952.
A pedestrian died in a road accident involving a car along Jalan Niur heading towards Chamek in Kluang, Johor at 9 p.m. yesterday. And the victim, Koh Bun Guan, age 48, suffered severe head injuries and died at the scene. Meanwhile, the driver and passengers escaped the incident unharmed. While Kluang District Police Chief ACP Muhammad Laham informed that the accident took place as the driver, T. Ling Seng, age 32, together with a mother and 5 children, were traveling from Jalan Niur towards Chamek. While Koh was unfortunately hit by the car while he was crossing the road. And the case is being investigated under Section 41, Subsection 1 of the Road Transport Act 1987. The Malaysian Civil Defense Department, or JPAM, yesterday successfully caught a 2.5-meter python that was slithering just outside a restaurant in Miri. And according to JPAM officer Muhammad Hazli Shah Abdul Hamid, the snake was found in front of a restaurant at Jalan Merdu at around 11:20 p.m. And Muhammad Hazli Shah said the reptile was first discovered by one of the workers at the restaurant who had tripped over it and quickly contacted JPAM Miri Operations Center for help. And a team from the department arrived at the scene at around 11:30 p.m. and it took them 30 minutes to capture the python. And the reptile was later brought to the JPAM Operations Center in Miri for further action. Road users of the Damansara Puchong Highway, or LDP, and Sprint Highway will enjoy a 60 cent and 20 cent toll discount, respectively, for all vehicle classes in conjunction with the upcoming Deepavali celebration on Wednesday. Now, the one-day discount will begin at 12 a.m. to 11:50 p.m. on October 18th. Now, Litron Group Chief Executive Officer Sazali Saidi in a press conference said almost 577,000 LDP and Sprint users will receive an estimated total subsidy of 280,000 ringgit through the discount provided. The initiative was part of both companies' corporate social responsibility. Litron today celebrated Deepavali with 30 orphans from the charity homes by taking them to the ICT theme park, Shah Alam, as location for the new reality television show, as well as the semi-final of the Miss Tourism International 2017 beauty pageant. And according to Langkawi Development Authority, LADA Chief Executive Officer Dato' Azizan Nurdin, the reality show entitled Differences Aside is to be produced by International Cable Television Network, CNN, in collaboration with Travel Leisure Channel, TLC.
Datu Azizan said the reality show will be something unique, where there will be 9 participants who come from other parts of the world to try the tourism activities in Langkawi.
Kita nak mempromosikan Langkawi to the next level. Sebab macam yang Mat Muhammad Perdana Menteri selalu kata, jadikanlah bagi Langkawi sebagai Monaco of the East. Kita tengok sekarang kita ada juga event-event lain macam sailing misalnya, kapal layar semua tu. Jadi kita nak mengelengahkan lagi produk-produk yang kaitan dengan luxury Langkawi.
He said this at an engagement dinner with tourism players held at a prestigious hotel in Langkawi. The participants would be from North America, United Kingdom, Kazakhstan, China, Japan, India, United Arab Emirates, Australia and Malaysia. Meanwhile, he said LADA was eyeing to set another new Malaysian record this year in conjunction with the 20th edition of the Miss Tourism International from November 30th till December 2nd. 60 contestants would be taking part in the beauty pageant, and a special title, Langkawi Tourism Ambassadress 2017, would be awarded to the best participant in the activities organized on the island.
In our top story, Malaysia to build hospital in Bangladesh for Rohingya refugees. Join us again at 12:30 tomorrow afternoon. I'm Amin Carlos. Stay tuned to TV2 and good night.